I've been with the fire department for 48 years now, and fire department, the police department, we're here only to serve the people of New York, and answer the call means just that. When we're in need, people answer the call. So we thank them for their generosity, and we ask them to keep it up.
The reason that we're supporting this is because they were made a promise at one time that the families will never be forgotten. And they gave their lives for us. We promised them that their family would not be suffering. Their family's gonna be taken care of with this organization. How beautiful is that?
It's hard to put into words, I think, how appreciative and thankful we are. But, you know, just thank you. Like you said very eloquently, it was, you know, that every day they put themselves in harm's way. And this event and this charity, having that peace of mind, the presence of mind to know that they can do their jobs and their families are going to be taken care of, I imagine that's huge for them and helps them do their job, you know, to the utmost of their abilities.
My grandfather was a New York City firefighter, my dad was a New York City firefighter, and my brother is a New York City cop. So it runs deep. Any firefighter, or first responder, or cop, or whoever they are, just thank you for being out there and protecting the people. And I think we take that for granted, especially being in New York, that we can walk around and be safe. But there's a reason why it's like that. And we have people like that taking care of us and watching out for us. And maybe it's because I feel connected to it, but it also is something that I always am mindful to be grateful for.
This is their opportunity to give back to these men and women, and especially their families. You know, these first responders are there when our city needs them, so now is their chance to be there when their families need us.
I would never take for granted our safety and our security and what these people do to put their lives on the line. So to give back in some small way by offering or getting involved with what this charity offers, it was just an easy decision.
A big reason New York is the best city in the world is because the first responders that we have here, and I think it's our duty to take care of them and their families when tragedy strikes. So I think what Answer the Call does year in and year out, it's really remarkable. And for me, I come from a family of firefighters, so this is a foundation that really hits close to home for me, so I'm always happy to come out and support.
When a brave man or woman sacrifices their lives in the line of duty, we promise to never forget that hero. We promise to never forget the family that hero has left behind. We know that there are many, many charities that you could have chosen to support tonight. The fact that you've chosen this charity and to be with us here tonight shows that the words never forget mean something to you as well. And for that, we are incredibly grateful.
The more word spread that we can have about this charity and this cause, and just in general, the more gratitude we can have for first responders and people serving our community, it's just the more the merrier, the more the better, and I couldn't be happier to be here to be a part of that.
I'm Dan Nigro, I'm the fire commissioner, and I'm proud to answer the call.
Hi, I'm Emily DiDonato. I am a supermodel, and I am proud to answer the call.
Hi, I'm Chris Kreider from the New York Rangers, and I'm proud to answer the call.
Hi, this is Rod Gilbert, former New York Rangers, and I'm proud to answer the call.
I'm Jennifer Lammers, I'm a news reporter, and I am proud to answer the call.
I'm Ryan Mara from the New York Red Bulls, and I'm proud to answer the call.
Hello, my name is Vincent Piazza, and I'm an actor, and I am very proud to answer the call.